Centennial, Chase.
Nicole?
How'd you get this number?
I remembered it. Take me?
You're drunk.
I'm desperate.
Oh. Well, when you put it that way.
You're not offended, so don't pretend to be.
Drive Me Crazy is an awesome movie about this super popular girl named Nicole who takes this loser named Chase under her wing and makes him the most popular guy in school, but then ends up actually falling for him, which is super awkward because their parents start dating at the end of the movie. So this movie is pretty much She's All That, but with the genders swapped. I would like to start by stating the obvious. This is the loser in question. Did the people behind this movie actually expect for us to believe that this is the biggest loser in school? This is Adrien Grenier, or however you say his last name, who would later go on to star in Entourage. He is, and has always been, fine as hell. So yeah, this movie really tried it with this one. At no high school in America or any other place in the world would this boy ever qualify as a loser. They didn't even do a good job of losering him up. Anyways, this movie stars Melissa Joan Hart, aka Sabrina the Teenage Witch, as Nicole, aka the most popular girl in school, and she's also the president of the student council because she is planning the big centennial school dance, which is the biggest deal ever in this movie. Melissa slays as the role of Nicole and truly comes off as effortlessly cool. So Nicole has her heart set on going to the centennial dance with the hottest guy in school / basketball superstar Brad, which would seem obvious because they're like seemingly dating or whatever. But then Nicole finds out that Brad is not into her anymore. And later on, she finds out that he's been messing around with her best friend. Side note, her bestie was the worst character in the movie. She was a horrible friend who spent literally the entire movie manipulating and betraying Nicole. Anyways, Brad obviously is not interested in Nicole anymore, but Nicole desperately wants to win Brad back over and go to the big dance with him. Then there is Chase, who has this wildly unhealthy relationship with his girlfriend. Chase and his girlfriend are total outcasts, but they seem to like it that way. They have no desire to be in with the in crowd, but Chase and his boo end up falling out, much like Nicole and Brad. Then one night, Nicole desperately flips through her yearbook to find a guy who's good enough to take her to the dance. So she conveniently lives next door to Chase. She reluctantly calls him and asks him to take her to the centennial dance. He is shocked that she even has his number, but she tells him that she remembered it from years ago when they were actually friends. Apparently, they have this huge falling out after Chase's mother tragically passed away, but the movie does not get into that so much. So, Chase tells a clearly intoxicated Nicole that she's drunk, and she hilariously says that she's not drunk, she's desperate. She tells him to sleep on it before drunkenly dropping her house phone out of the window. So Chase and Nicole agree to pretend to date each other so that Nicole can win back over Brad and so that Chase can win back his ex-girlfriend. Chase gets this super preppy makeover and looks like a Gap poster boy, and no one can believe it, especially not his ex-girlfriend, who is not impressed by the makeover and tells Chase not to let Nicole change him. She comes off as super jealous, so it appears that Chase and Nicole fake dating is totally working, and all the girls start ogling over Chase, which is really funny because honestly, I thought that he looked better before the makeover. Chase soon becomes a part of the in crowd, much to the dismay of his friends who think that he has changed for the worst, a la Katie and Mean Girls after her makeover. Chase and Nicole hang out more and more, and their chemistry gets stronger and stronger, and it's clear that they are totally starting to fall for each other. They even get super jealous when they think that the other one is with someone else during a misunderstanding at a party where Chase sees Nicole with Brad, and Nicole sees Chase with her man-stealing bestie. This jealousy that they had about the misunderstanding at the party solidifies that they like each other, and maybe even they're totally in love. So Chase and Nicole break up, but it's super weird since they were never really together. But since they did actually really like each other, they're both totally devastated by the breakup. However, Nicole and Chase end up reconciling and being each other's date to the big centennial dance after all, where they finally reveal their true feelings for each other. So then the movie ends with them going back to their houses, which of course are next door to each other, and they discover that their parents, her mom and his dad, have been dating one another and are planning to move in together, meaning that Chase and Nicole will be living together, and if their parents decide to marry, they'll be step-siblings. But this would only be weird AF if Chase and Nicole stayed together, which they probably wouldn't. They would definitely be broken up by graduation. So Drive Me Crazy proves to be an awesome movie about a girl falling for the boy next door that she never thought she could like because they were in different cliques. But once they reconnect and get to know each other for what's on the inside and not focus on popularity or social standing, then they quickly found that they did in fact like each other for who they really were. What other movies like Drive Me Crazy about an unexpected romance, two friends becoming lovers, or teens whose parents start dating do you love? Let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel.